Wow.
Mmm, so crunchy and crispy. Wow.
Hey everyone, I'm Steph. Chris is behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are in Georgetown, Penang, a city that is known for being one of the top street food destinations in Malaysia. We're really excited for a day full of eating today, as well as checking out one of the historic areas of the city, the Clan Jetties. So come on, let's go. Traditional Indian breakfast of roti canai, except this time we've got it with eggs and cheese. This looks insane. The cheese is so melty. I think we've got 2 eggs on there. Look at that cheese. Oh my god.
Wow.
That's insane. Oh, look at that. Wow, cheese is so good and melty. And not too salty actually. There's so much cheese in the center here. Oh my gosh. Talk about a breakfast. Get a nice tip. So nice with the cheese, it's so gooey. The egg is so rich, and the curry sauce, it's got such a nice kick to it. It's spicy, look at that, just clings to it. This is definitely a perfect calorie rich breakfast to start the day. And it's so cool, the place here, it's just kind of like outside amongst the trees off the side of the road. Really, really cool atmosphere. The roti's cooked so nice as well. It's got a nice little crisp and char to the outside, but it's lovely and soft and layered on the inside. You can see all the layers there. It's so lovely. The roti is really, really nice. And lovely dipped in curry sauce. And cooled off with the tea tart. I can never get enough of these. Oh, look at that yolk. Oh my gosh. That's so good.
Delicious.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
That was such a good roti canai. Thank you. ginger.
Yeah, this one ginger. The fresh ginger.
Fresh ginger.
This one is the powder. This one the olive fresh one.
Oh wow, yeah.
Okay.
The I can smell it.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Such a strong smell of ginger.
Yeah. Amazing.
You like it, huh? You want drinks?
Yeah.
Hot or cold?
Hot. Hot is very nice your body.
Ah, okay.
You are like everything good. Okay.
All
ice,
right.
Not good for your body.
One hot.
Okay, you see the ginger? Okay. Like this.
Smells incredible.
Incredible.
Yeah. Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Look at this.
We're here at the famous tea halia to try their tea halia, which is a ginger tea. Now, this is really popular in Southeast Asia, and the way they do it here is they actually use fresh ginger that they've steeped and boiled with tea, condensed milk, they pull and tarik it. It was so fun to watch, and I just can't wait to try it. The froth on there looks lovely, and the smell of the ginger, so strong. Wow. Oh my gosh, that's delicious. There's such a strong raw ginger flavor with that. And definitely getting it hot, I think, was a good decision because it adds to the warmth of the ginger. Mmm. Oh, man. Oh, gosh, it's so good. That's delicious. So good. The hot is perfect. Yeah. Yeah. I'm glad that we got it the hot, because you can feel just the warmth of the ginger in your throat. This is amazing, wow. And with the condensed milk and taricking it, makes it so creamy. I've had ginger things before and it's almost too overpowering, but this is just perfect. It has a lot of great health benefits drinking it hot as opposed to cold as well. And I can already feel it in my throat, in my body. This is definitely the way you need to drink it. I think it's actually cooling me down on this hot day as well. This is nice.
Lies.
We were chatting with the shop owner and he was saying that he's the third generation and his son is taking over the business and is going to be the fourth generation. So if you're going to try the tea halia, you definitely have to come here to the famous tea halia to try it. You will not regret it. And look at these cute mugs. Thank you so much.
Okay, bye-bye.
See you again.
See you again.
Bye-bye. That really does the body good. We're here now at the Clan Jetties. Now these houses built on stilts over the water were built in the 19th century and were home to the first Chinese immigrants in the area. Now each jetty houses a clan of a common surname and the descendants of them still live here to this day. So it's really, really cool to see all these lovely houses still standing.
here to try the prawn fritters and the lo bok. Now, lo bok is pork marinated in five spice and wrapped in a bean curd and then deep fried. So she cut up a bunch of pieces there. You get this awesome little stick so you don't have to get your fingers all oily. Mmm. So nice and hot. Mmm. The pork is kind of like a minced pork. Oh, you really taste that Chinese five spice flavor to that. And the bean curd gives it a nice crunch because it's been deep frying in there. Oh, that is tasty. Wow. Let's get another one here. Mmm. Mmm. Very good. Rosega. Very good. Ooh, look at that lo bok. And she poured some chili sauce all over it as well. You can see the, it wrapped in the bean curd there. Mm, really flavorful. That five spice really comes out, jumps out that flavor. Mm, let's get in on this prawn fritter here. Look at that. So it's batter with a bunch of different little prawns in there. I'm pretty sure they're shelled still too. Still got the shell on. Mmm, so crunchy and crispy. Wow. Oh yeah, you can really taste the shrimp in there. Little pieces of shrimp and just a nice deep fried batter. Got a nice oily taste to it as well. Mmm, really flavorful. This is a great little snack here by the Jetties with this shop right here. Let's continue on.
Thank you.
The most popular jetty among tourists, where a lot of the houses have turned the fronts of the houses into stores to sell things. Hello. A lot of kind of like touristy gift shops and things like that, so a cool use of the houses on the water here. We're here at the Jetty food court to try the Penang version of the chi cheng fun. Now this is different than the Cantonese version that we've had before because the rice noodles are actually in rolls and it comes with these special sauces. So we have a prawn paste sauce, a sweet dark soy sauce, and a chili kind of chili paste sauce. And there's dried shallots on the top as well. So this should be interesting and really yummy.
Delicious.
To try.
Yeah, I think sesame oil as well.
Yes, poured sesame oil over the top.
Do it.
Cheers.
Cheers. Mmm. Oh, that's nice.
Mmm. Mm. So the rice noodles are actually hot because they've been steaming in like the steamer. And yeah, that prawn, that brown kind of prawn paste is really nutty and almost kind of like peanut flavor.
It's really, really good. And the sweet soy sauce is interesting well because it's quite sweet. But salty at the same time, and with the noodles covered in the sesame oil, that's actually really, really nice. It's such a good flavor.
Lots of flavors going on there.
And the noodles are so nice and chewy as well.
Let's try some of the spicy.
Oh, going for the spicy.
Ooh. Chili sauce is very spicy. Oh, adds a really hot kick to that. Ooh.
That's nice. I used less than you, and I think that was the better amount.
Yeah.
And it's nice with the little fried onions on top too. Gives it a kind of a nice little crisp.
Mm.
But these are so cute how they're a roll like that. So, so nice. These are really tasty. A nice little snack type of a meal.
Let's have the ultimate bite.
Verdict, verdict.
This is some good churn fun.
This is nice. I really like this. To be honest, with the rolls and the sauce, this is quite different than we've had in Malaysia so far.
Yeah, each bite with the it being rolled is almost like more kind of bite to it because you get more noodle, rice noodle in there. And the jetty food court here is right by the jetties, the Clan Jetties outside. And it's actually a really big food court where you can find lots of different food in here. So if you're ever around the jetties, taking a tour of the jetties out there, this is definitely a cool place to come and cool down and get some awesome food.
I was gonna say that, nice and cool as well. With big fans, shade, tasty food, can't go wrong.
Here waiting in line for some fruit rojak.
I can't get another. Okay, huh?
Blindfolded cutting.
Okay, right.
What skill?
Ooh.
Wow.
Woo. Been here for 40 years?
Yeah. Okay. Then I jumpa. Ah, can you move here by this year? Ah. Until apa? Okay.
We're here at Aceh Rojak to try McCollum's best rojak. Now rojak is kind of like a fruit salad and it has like a peanut prawn kind of sweet sauce and they sprinkled it with peanuts as well as it looks like dried shrimp there. So a really odd combination of ingredients, but the fruit looks refreshing. That's a piece of pear. Ooh, really crunchy fruit, nice and fresh, juicy, and the peanuts add such a nice crunch to it as well. The sauce is kind of like, yeah, kind of like a sweet, almost savory with a shrimp taste to it. Really interesting, to be honest. It looks like there's apple and pineapples and pears in here. The pineapple's so sweet, and yeah, the peanut sauce, nice and nutty. Not too sweet though, the sauce. This is a Penang specialty, this rojak, this fruit rojak. Got big chunks of fruit here as well. Squid, fried donut fritter, fruit. Everything is so crunchy. The dried shrimps that he sprinkled on as well really brings out the shrimp flavor in the sauce as well. What an interesting fruit dish. Nice and refreshing with the juicy fruit on a hot day. This is good.
This is the Protestant cemetery where the prominent British colonialists were buried in the 1700s and 1800s. Penang Hokkien mee or prawn mee. Now this is a really, really popular noodle soup here in Penang. And we've got egg noodles in a pork bone and prawn broth, as well as pork, prawns, and egg, shallots on the top, bean sprouts. Look at all that. Oh man, look at all these noodles. Looks like it's gonna be a little spicy with the redness of it. Noodles are lovely and chewy. It's got quite a strong prawn flavor to it, actually. A little bit of spice. Broth is quite clear. It's got a little kick to it, but actually not as spicy as I was first expecting. Definitely a strong prawn flavor to it. That's nice though. Got some pork. Pork is really nice with it, tender. And tastes really nice actually with the prawn broth. See if we can find a little prawn around here. Ooh, there one is. Look a little, looks like it might be a little fried or something like that actually. Interesting. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, it's a little bit crispy on the outside almost. With the bean sprout. It's really tasty actually. Looks like we got a nice piece of marinated egg as well in here. And this is completely different to the Hokkien mee that you find in KL, which is actually a char Hokkien mee, so it's a fried noodle. So different. It's crazy how different some of the dishes are in Malaysia as you go from city to city, region to region. Look at this nice piece of pork. Really complements the prawn really, really well. This is a lovely, lovely soup. I really like this.
Here now at Economy Bee Hoon to try the char bee hoon, which is a rice vermicelli noodle that's walked up. Vermicelli is my favorite type of noodle, so I can't wait to try this.
Hello.
Thank you.
gosh. So much noodle. Got our vermicelli here and can't forget about my peanut soup. And our peanut soup dessert. We're here at the famous economy bee hoon to try the bee hoon here. Now this is the fried white vermicelli and we had to get it with some spring roll here and some lobak, which we had earlier today, which is the pork that's wrapped in the bean curd. And of course, we had to get a bowl of peanut soup for dessert later. Nice hot peanut soup. Gotta try some of the noodle first. Look at this freshly walked vermicelli. Wow, such nice flavor. You really taste the soy sauce that he puts on there and walks up. The bean sprouts are nice and crunchy, and I love vermicelli because it's such a light noodle. You can really taste the wok high, the breath of the wok from the high temperature that he kind of cooks the vermicelli in. It really gives it like a charred, kind of smoky flavor to the noodle.
Perfect.
Try it with a bit of the lobak. It's almost kind of like a sausage, how it's wrapped in the bean curd casing. Wow, that really goes nice with it. Almost, yeah, like a sausage and noodle. This is my favorite food today. Gotta try a nice crispy spring roll as well. Doesn't look like, not sure what's in there. Maybe just rice noodle? Looks super crispy though. Really crunchy.
That's crispy.
Goes perfect with the noodles. We also got the hot peanut soup dessert, which they are famous for here as well at Economy Bee Hoon. Looks like there's nice chunks of peanut in there. Really smell that peanut nutty flavor. Oh. I had to do a double take there because the peanuts are so soft. I was expecting them to be crunchy, but I guess because they've been cooking for so long, they're actually super mushy. It's interesting. Really nutty flavor though. It's not too sweet, and yeah, the peanuts really give it a interesting flavor because they're so mushy. Definitely dessert tasting because it's sweetness, but really throwing off that the peanuts aren't crunchy at all. This is delicious though. A nice way to end this meal here with the vermicelli. That's really tasty. The Bee Hoon Vermicelli here at Economy Bee Hoon is a can't miss spot in Penang, and we definitely recommend coming here to try the Bee Hoon as well as get some of this delicious peanut soup. That does it for our Penang food tour today. We hope you enjoyed us showing you some of the flavors of the city. If you did, give the video a like, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below and let us know what the tastiest food you saw was. And make sure you subscribe to our channel to join us on all of our food adventures. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.